Hey guys, just another gamer here, and currently I'm actually running on the Rift level 5. So apparently so far this is like my team, and I'm accompanied by two guildies. So this is the guy who is currently first, Valkyrin, and another friend of mine, which will be ofuro. So now the dragon is like the, I think like every 75%, then 50%, and subsequently at 25% HP, he'll be doing that skill, or that fly skill. I think it's this, actually I have no idea which skill is this. Yep, yeah, this is a skill, total annihilation. So he actually removes all the harmful effects, then he will just attack you. So actually technically I don't really understand much about this guy's skill, but so far, if you guys ask me about like what works and what doesn't work, I would say that the Dark Death Knight, that will work. Chasun is also from rather like common. So another alternative that ofuro is using as compared to Diaz, he's actually using on the Darien, because it's like being said that this 15% reduction of damage, that passive actually works pretty well. And then right after that, what we actually want, which will be like the cleansers. So for my case, I have Delphoi and Anivale. And the frontline for my case, which will be Delphoi, Diaz and Chasun. Then backline will be Colin, Tessarion and Anivale. Then for Valkyrie, oh yeah, this will be the Desert Queen that I was talking about in some of my videos. So actually the Water Desert Queen does help a lot in giving the debuffs from the second skill. Then he also uses a Hua, which is like a tanky Hua. So yep, that actually helps somehow in giving a slow and also reducing on that boss attack bar. Yep, Chasun is like rather common, and Colin is also very common here in the Rift Raids, because every, I think 3 turns, you actually heal like 25% and you give attack buff. So alternatively, for healer instead of Colin, I feel that what ofuro is using is the area, which could also help him out. And then his cleanser, which will be Konamiya and also Fedora. So for Valkyrie, he's using, oh, is it using only just one of the cleansers, but then he has Hua to actually keep the boss down so that he will still be able to like continue on with his own stuff. Because if you do not give the boss too many turns, I mean, then cleansers might not that really quite needed. So for lineups wise, I think that it's everything all about like the, I'll say that most of it is together with your strategy. So for my case, Anivale over Konamiya. Why is that so? Is that my Anivale holds like quite a fair bit of like the pedal wounds of my case, and that also makes me then think that I have not much of a reason to actually make a Konamiya, because I feel that other than the research part, Anivale actually excels more in terms of the damage of a Konamiya, and with my current set of wounds, which is a little bit crazy kind, so I think that it actually exceeds or excels way more than what it's supposed to give. So for, in terms of benchmark for like this, because there is this, let me check the skill. Yeah, but I think it's this Crush of Doom. It says that the damage increases substantially as the target's defense decreases. So what we actually do is that we will wound our mobs, especially for the front line. Other than for my case on Chasun, we will put like one slot of the defense percent in either 2-4, I mean usually the 4 or 6, because you use like speed on the second slot. Even my Colin is also on like speed, HP and defense. For what reason wise is like not really a difference, because if I put double HP, but then if I would use like my revenge or my violent wounds for Colin for the HP, I think that I'm using quite a fair bit of my resources, which defense percent seldom is being used that really much. So now the boss is on the 25% mark. Then for our leader skill, I'm actually using Tessarion. Wow. Okay, so that's Tessarion is for the 41% resistant lead. Then for Valkyrin, he's using on the defense because I'm using on the resist, so I took on that spot. The defense percent is from Bastet, the Water Desert Queen, and then ofuro is okay. He made a major sacrifice by using a Ramos because Ramos isn't really that quite much of a need in my opinion, because he's usually more to just doing the dots or the second skill, which is not able to actually produce any form of like the debuffs on the boss. So he actually making a fair bit of sacrifice with that. Maybe I should probably utilize my Ramos next time when I when it's like if I have no choice on that. So as you can see that earlier there were like many debuffs on his team, so I think that maybe two cleansers is still a better idea. Okay, so talking about this, we have the total, then we have the damage. We actually are on the same page. Okay, and then assist. Okay, my assist isn't that really good, but I'm like using a fair bit of attackers because Enervil and also for my Tesseract, they are both the damage base. The rest of them are like more like supports. But rather for Enervil, her role is more like minor bit of DPS, and at the same time she will be the one doing the cleanse. And then if there's Chasun's heal, the Chasun's or Colin's the attack buff, I'll be able to heal another 1.5 times, which is around like 12k for my case, which like now I need probably the cleanse because slow is like rather irritating. Oh, he lost his Hua. I guess probably that's when the 25% mark. But we'll still survive because you know sometimes there are like a fair bit of ING. My team isn't like the best. There are still like others who are way better than mine in the guild. So don't look up to my teams. I mean, you can actually have like something of your specialty on your kind of team. Wow, okay, yeah, you see, told you, you shouldn't just follow my team because I also do, my units also still die. And one shot, I lost two units. So Mana Stone, yep. That's quite nice, he gets the real HP percent. Because, I mean, I'm like quite a freak on the violent and will. Other than that, maybe on rich set. Alright, so earlier on I was taking a break, then now we are continuing on. So I just realized that also in terms of if you do not have a Diaz, I think that Fedora and also Darien could actually work out well, because Diaz has this shield block, that shield which reduced on the incoming passive, and then Fedora also has the cleanse, which can also work like as though I'm like having a Diaz and Kona. So that's could also work it out quite well. Or if you only use like a Diaz and Kona, you probably want to look out for like a Delphoi kind, because I still feel that two of these cleansers is like rather substantial. That's in my opinion. Maybe you guys have a different opinion, or if you guys have like a way faster team in order to deal against the Reef level 5, or we call it R5 in short. So the problem with this, okay, damage is around like that. My damage will drop like subsequently, like around, we'll end up like around 30%. I think like we are quite equal for this case. We have another guildie whereby if he's inside, he will garner like around 50% of the damage. So the thing about this assist is like a little bit weird. So the guy who actually first land on, like, example, this heal block, or the defense break or the attack break, we need a glance like soon. Can the glance come in soon? Okay, so okay, yeah, we had the glance now. Yep, so the person who actually land that first will get that 1 point. So it's like out of the many points, how many turns did you actually get that this debuff on? Then that's how roughly it's calculated. Then So what we actually do is, like, take for example, we add the damage plus the axis, then we divide it by 2. That's like the total. That's how they actually calculate the total. Yep, so the boss is like, is it midway through? I'm not sure how long my runs are, but I feel that if we just focus mainly on just surviving first, and then like, it's just something like how I did for like Necropolis, whereby everybody will be doing like 3 attackers and then 2 supports. So now I'm actually moving it to like 4 plus 1. So for now, my case right here is like, Tessa is like a full damage dealer. Then Anvil wise, how do I how to call her? Probably I'll just make it like around 4.5 plus 1.5. Yeah, I mean 1.5 plus 4.5 instead, because 1.5 which is the attacker, but then 4.5 which will be like the support. And my DS is like having Nemesis set, which I don't quite really see anything working from the Nemesis. It could probably be because that I max up on the HP percent for the, I use double HP percent and then a defense percent, so apparently it doesn't seem to be making the Nemesis work out at all. So what, I'm not sure what I'm going to do next, but I can't like down the level of that rune back to like plus 12 or plus 13. Plus 14. Let's just go through on those. Okay, so this will be the last one. So for my case, this is like the rough stats. So it's like 122k KHP and then around 1.3k defense, alright? Because my Delphoi is like a PvP base and it's like higher on the accuracy, especially for the reset of the cooldowns. So you have like around 28k HP and then 1.6k defense, but Chasun wise is like more lopsided on the HP, not much on the defense. I'm looking for more runes for that. Then we'll just take a look at the current, I mean just for the front line this time. So for this we have like 34k plus 1.3k. This is like around 26k plus 1.6k. This is 30k plus 1.6. So are they all wipe out? Okay, so for this front line, that will be just these two. It'll be 24k plus 2k. Actually his stats is very good. And then for this is like around 24k plus 2.1k defense. So probably might see more areas which are like super high on each defense. Yep, he got wiped out. I guess probably they say that if you actually put in like around 25k kind of HP with like around 1.5k kind of defense, that's for your front line, you should be able to survive. But mine isn't that really on the dot of that kind of level, so I actually placed like 3 units in front. And the world can't really tank well because it went lesser HP and it went more to attack this time due to the recent change I did like last Monday or something. Yep. We will be able to survive. Yep, we will be able to survive because this guy's lineup is very very tanky. He's usually the last one to survive, not me, because I'm like more towards the attack side. But okay, so if he actually just maintains this, I can actually survive this show. And I think that look at that. I told you that my units might not be able to survive either. And that is like when I'm only tanking one hit, whereas he's like tanking 2 hits. Okay, so my DS is also down and I'm only left here like calling for like the main healer. Oh crap. So everything will now be on him, but he should actually make it through. Come on, I can do it, man. Just a few more hits. Yeah, and Proha's really good in the raids. Okay, there's a heal block there, so the boss won't heal and he should be able to clear this off. So if I were to move like soon, etc. Oh man. Just one more bit. We might pull this through. Alright, see. He's at the tankiest one, but it can't really tank too much, but it's 3 hits, mind you guys. Yep, I guess that's all for what we have today. Then I'll see you guys for tomorrow's video, which will be for the Hall of Heroes. Yep, so thanks guys for watching and goodbye.